Okay, good morning. It is July 12th, correct? Yeah. Monday, July 12th. Matt Wright's here,
Jeremy Elliott.
long hair, and Jeremy Elliott with the hat. That's our trademarks. We just got done with some phone calls, answering emails. We were having an issue with a certain situation that came up. Somebody was mentioning, I guess having issues with the fact, well, let me speak on that. This is a good thing to talk about without mentioning names and all that. The thing is, the bottom line is that me and Jeremy are non-judgmental people. And the situation we're talking about is a certain person was murdered, and we've dealt with that spirit a lot, this dude, that dude. But then again, the people that were responsible for the person dying, we're not judging them either. And in fact, the mother of one of the persons who's responsible has died and has come through to us before. In fact, I see her right now.
Yeah, it makes
But
situations awkward when we answer questions.
from both sides.
Yeah, from the non-judgmental point of view, I think it's something that we've been dealing with since birth, just being non-judgmental people. So,
It's hard when we can't say, oh, this person's bad. But it's hard for people to understand that. Like, if somebody's a serial killer, even, I'm like, they're not bad. They're not bad people. I'm not judging them. If someone's a child molester, even, I'm not going to even judge that.
Yeah, I mean, my parents always said to me that I picked the wrong people to hang out with all the time. Like, I didn't.
Same thing with me.
Yeah, but it's like maybe they weren't the wrong people. The thing was, I wasn't judging them for their actions or who they were or how they acted or.
That's
I just was
right.
looking past that no matter what, and it was up to them if they wanted to be my friend, for life or not, it was on them.
I always hung out with the bad kids when I was in school. So-called bad kids. I never liked hanging out with the goody two shoes kids, as you could call them. It never made sense to me because I never thought to kiss ass to authority and all this stuff,
Yeah, I
and
never thought
I've
of that.
never believed in it. And I understand the people who misbehave and act wild better. I understand the criminals and the junkies and the fiends
Yeah, because it's natural.
and the killers and all of them. I relate
All that is natural.
to their pain.
You know that these people are being real to their own desires and wants and thoughts and needs. So you kind of feel that reality. You can see them holding back out of fear. Their parents or the
Parents,
authorities.
authorities, and some people just step out and do anything. They're not worried about it. They're out there hustling, robbing, shooting, whatever, and they're not thinking about it. Not that I agree with every action someone might take, but I don't have to agree with it not to be non-judgmental. I might not approve all the way of them killing people, for example, but yet I'm not going to sit there and tell them, you're going to hell and you're worthless and you're a criminal.
You're worthless.
That's a lie. No one's not worthless.
No one. Everyone has.
Everyone has worth.
Everyone has purpose. Like I said, it's all natural. Like when the lion kills the deer, it just happens. When they say, the lion, that's instinct, or the lion needs to feed and stuff. Well, sometimes people are feeding the desire themselves to pull the trigger. That's horrible, maybe, but at the same time, I can't say it's not natural, and I should,
condemn
always,
it.
I can
I
always,
can't condemn it
what do
anything.
you say, just throw that human being away at that point,
Yeah, they're suddenly worthless, and they never can do good
It
again.
just doesn't make sense to us that way. I
Not
mean,
at all.
maybe to other people, and that's natural too, but,
Some people want judgment and justice, so-called justice, and punishment.
I understand that
The universe don't work like
that's
that.
human conditioning. It's not universe. It's not the infinite. It's not the universe saying to us what's the correct thing to do. But love all things with compassion. You have to have compassion for the next, what happens. Unfortunately, sometimes in this race of the living human race, we sit there and we're afraid of death. We're afraid. We have certain conditions, what's good and bad,
That's true.
What's worse than others, what deserves hell. I mean, we've made a lot of judgment calls, as human beings, but It's pretty much not
misplaced judgment isn't necessary.
It's not necessary, you know. Look, I can understand, like, you know, you don't always say, oh, you don't judge pedophiles and stuff. Well, you know, yeah, I'm not gonna ask them to babysit or anything, you know, or take them, you know, I might skip their, you know, like I heard a song in the movie, the guy said, I'm not gonna ask them to babysit or take them to their house to go trick or treating or anything, you know, maybe that's not the best idea, but at the same time, you know, they are people with souls that need healing and renourishing too, you know.
So that's why we don't condemn anyone, because we're all part of the infinite. We're all gods and goddesses and part of the infinite light. Whether you do bad or you do good in life, saints and sinners, or you could say it like that, one way to put it. And it just goes in, it deals with a lot of this stuff. Like, we're not trying to intentionally hurt or cause anyone pain by anything we say on this board here, on these comments. But sometimes, like, truth is truth. And then, like, the comment I posted last night about that when we watch the news, like, you know, when someone dies violently in Richmond around, I commented that, you know, since I've been hours, there I am talking with them, and there we are already talking with them, helping them out, you know, doing the best we can. Sometimes we go to them and check with them to be sure they're all right. Sometimes they find us. But I don't condemn them, you know. I've helped people who killed people and then killed themselves, murder, suicide people. I've helped them cross over to the highest levels of the spirit world, from self-imposed exile dimensions. I took serial killers and helped them. Serial killers who died, took them through, you know.
Yeah, I took a beetle through the portal today.
You did?
Yeah, honestly, it was suffering on the floor, and I could tell it had been there for a long time, and I thought it was dead, and I picked it up, and it was still moving a little bit. I said, it has to go, you know, so I killed it.
Yeah.
And I said, I'm sorry, that's probably the best thing for you, man, you know, you're not going to survive.
Yeah.
And then I said, don't be afraid, and I took it through the portal, you know.
You could see it in the portal.
Yeah, I could see it go through, I was like, come on through, you know.
Even the bugs go to the other side. That's another truth. The fly even crosses over and lives forever.
I was like, don't trip. I think it was tripping a little bit, like, why this human being killed me? I strive to suffer to live so long, you know. Well, you aren't.
So you explained it.
Yeah, I was saying you weren't going to live to be that long. You know, anyway, you were going one direction, so I was just trying to help. You know, the
that's probably appropriate.
I mean, otherwise, I would have took it outside if I thought it would have made it or something, but I don't think that was the case.
Yeah,
I wanted to end its suffering, wanted to smack. You know.
There you go. Yeah, that's something else too, you know. Compassion just comes in a lot of different forms, and you know, to those, like, we're gonna start, as I put in my comment, I think we're gonna get back to what we used to do as far as listing these guys that come through to us in the spirit world. We're gonna make lists and post them online so you can read them and see who you know. You never know. It might be people in your own family that have been trying to reach you, and you didn't know it, you know? Don't be afraid to get in touch with us, you know? Yeah. Some of you, we've been dealing with certain situations we deal with for months at a time. There's one in this particular, you know? Like, you know, we've gone to the ends of the earth and back for this spirit and this people, you know? And I always will, you know?
And, you know, well,
we'll do that for whoever needs it.
Just remember that we're doing the best we can. We're not trying to say anything to influence anyone, or we're not condoning bad things or good or whatever. You know, we're under the microscope now. You know, like
we are. Yes,
we're being looked at.
Yeah,
by the public eye, and the different people watching our words and stuff. You know, so.
We're trying to disseminate truth the best way we can.
Yeah, we learn from certain things. We're not perfect, you know, but we're trying to do the best we can. You know?
That's why I want you to drop us a line if you feel like something we've done could have been done better, or you have certain feelings, positive or negative, about something. Feel free to speak your mind. Drop us a line.
Yeah,
we're happy to hear. We're not going to get upset.
No,
we'll be happy to hear what you